Hello everyone and welcome back to another tutorial. In this tutorial we will be going through how to add bones to the hair of this Dragon Ball Z style character that we have created before. It is the same process that we have used for the cat tail from the previous tutorial. We will convert these bones into spring bones and have the secondary motion for the hair of this character. This was a suggestion by one of the subscribers. Thank you for your suggestion. And these are the final results of this tutorial. Let's get right into it. So this was the final result from the part 2 of this tutorial series. So in order to add bones to the existing skeleton of this character, we need to convert this into a humanoid character. So let's go to File and Export and click on FBX Clothed Character. Select the Blender preset over here and we just need the mesh, so select that. And in the default pose, select T pose and everything else can be at default. Let's export this character. Let's import the same character back into Character Creator. Select the option Character and then select Humanoid. Character Creator will detect the profile of actor build, but in order to add the bones to the head, we need to cancel this option and do the characterization by our own. So in order to do the characterization, you can simply double click on the bone on this preview here and then select the bone in the viewport. You can also turn on the mirror option over here. So when you choose the bones on the left side of the character, the other side is automatically selected. Similarly, you can do the same for the fingers as well. You can turn on the select child bones option here. So it will automatically select the child bones. You just need to select the main bone over here. And now that the characterization is done, we'll click on Active. And now we will use the Blender Pipeline plugin. I'll leave the link in description and I'll show you the process from the previous video of how to install it. So go to the installation folder of CC4 and go to bin64 folder. Make a new folder called Open Plugin. And you can extract the plugin into this folder. And now you can restart the CC4 application. You can come back to Character Creator and now go to the Blender Pipeline, Export Character. Over here, you can select Mesh Only and make sure that these two options are selected along with the current pose because we need the T pose for the character. And export this character. And now we'll come back to Blender, go to Edit, Preferences, and in the Add-ons menu, you'll have the option to Install. Click on Install and select the zip file that you have downloaded. And you can turn on the plugin over here. Click N on your keyboard to show the CC plugin. Over here, you can click on Import Character and select the file that you have exported from CC. Over here, you can go to the front orthographic view. Simply select any of the bones and go to Viewport Display and click on In Front. And over here, you can search for Head and then select CC Base Head option. Go to the Edit mode and then click E to extrude bone. And you can make two additional child bones. Go to the side orthographic view and simply select each bone and place it based on the position of the hair. Once this is done, you can simply click A to select all and then click on export to CC4. We can save this as Blender export. And now we'll go back to Character Creator. Go to the plugins and Blender pipeline. You can import the character that you have exported from Blender. You can leave all the options at default, and when it asks for applying the actor build preset, click on cancel. This will automatically apply the characterization. And now you can go to Bone Manager and search for head. Select all the bones below head and click on used. And now you can start doing the skin weights. Click on the skin weights option and then go to scene, select the hair mesh. Let's rename this to hair. And now in the bone manager, you can select the bone that you need to assign the skin weights. Let's go to the selection option here and select the vertices that I want to apply. We'll click on grow and then select the vertices from this point and click 1 to apply the skin weight. So this turns completely white, which means this part of the hair is 100% controlled by this particular bone. And similarly, we'll select the other bone over here and we'll roughly select vertices from the top and click on grow. Deselect some of the vertices that I don't want to be converted. And we will flush it with 1, which means this part of the hair is 100% controlled by this particular bone. And now we'll go to the paint option and we'll use the smooth brush to smooth out all the faces of this hair. So make sure you smooth out all the parts of the hair so there are no deformations when the spring bones are in action. And now let's go to edit springs. Let's select these bones over here and activate it. And also change the spring type to rotate. Let's apply an animation over here just to check if the spring bones are working properly. So whenever we apply a motion to this character, the spring bones turns off. So let's turn that on over here. This wayward motion is because we have applied the spring to this bone over here, so we need to turn that off. For this bone, let's keep the spring type as rotate, but for the top end bone, let's change it to translate. Because I want this part of the hair to move and not just rotate, so I'll just keep it at translate. We'll reduce the mass to around 2, increase the strength to 11. And that's how you can create spring bones for the hair that we have created for this character. Thanks for watching.